Hello, welcome back again on this new video. If you like Tableau, don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Today we are going to talk about donor chart, you know, how to, you know, build a donor chart with Tableau. As we have noticed, you know, donor chart is something that is, you know, already, you know, is a chart that is available on all the BI tools, you know, like Google Data Studio. You know, donor chart is available on it and many other, you know, BI tools. But in Tableau, you have to come up with it, you have to build it up, you know. Actually, it doesn't come handy, right? So you start from a pie chart and then you make up a donor chart. So without wasting time, let's jump right into it. We are trying to build up something like this, right? You know, these are the various categories. We are trying to use actually the global superstore data, you know, data set, which is right here, right? And then we try to plot here, you know, the categories by the, you know, the profits. That's what we're trying to insert. We have the total profit, and then on each, you know, part of the donut, you know, this is something that looks really like a donut, right? We have technology, office supply, and then furniture, and then this is the percentage of profit they made for various, you know, of these categories. So we are trying to build up something like this, and without, you know, wasting further time, let's jump right into it. So the first thing we need to do, since we are building up on the categories, is to pick up categories, you know, on the dimension here. So you put it into the color. So we have, you know, this category, then we have three different categories, and clearly you can see the color, you know. And now if you want to, you can change the coloring, you know. I'm just trying to be very mindful of, you know, people that may be colorblind. So that's why I just, you know, choose this, you know, easier, you know, this color. I believe is friendly, and anyone that may have any, you know, color blindness, you know, should be able to watch this video without any problem. Now, next thing that we need to do is to come down to the marks pane, right? You know, when you come down to this marks, below the mark, you know, right here, we have automatic. So automatic, this is, you know, when I move the categories to color, this just came up automatically. Now you can change that, and I'm going to change it to use a pie chart. So it's going to give me a pie chart, actually, a pie, right? Now this is too, it looks small. Let's make it, you know, fit the entire wave, you know, entire view, which is much more better. Now over here, clearly you can see we have various categories, but we do not have, you know, the value inside. And what we need to do is use the profit right here. Okay, we want to have the profit on the label side, right? Because we want to have the profit outside, right? And next thing we may want to have is also on the categories, to have them you know, shown outside. And to do so, you can come, you move the categories, you know, to the label side, and then we have them outside. And someone will tell me, okay, I want to have technology up, and then, you know, the profit beneath it. So if you want to do that, you can just change this, right? Move bottom, and then this one at the top, and then we have it here. Next thing, we do not want to have a total profit. We want to have percentage of profit. The total, we want to have it in the middle. And to do that, profit that we want to change, you know, to percentage of total. So you come down to quick calculation, you scroll down to percent of total, and then boom, you have it changed, and then you have the percentage of profit. Next thing that we need to do is to create, right? To come down here and then to create average of zero, actually. So you come down to AVG of zero, right? Then you create something like this. And we want to have it, you know, we want to duplicate it. So you press on control or command if you are using Mac to have it twice, right? Right. So yeah, this is it. The next thing that we may want to do is to get rid of, because we want to use this at the top, and then, you know, use a circle here to put it inside to have this donut, right? So this right here at the bottom, we want to have the white. Let me show you some right here. This white one, actually, that's the one at the bottom. So this very one, we want to turn into the white one, the circle, and then put it inside here. That's what we're trying to do. And to do that, we need to get rid of all the metrics inside. So when you look at these on the average of zero, we have them right here again. They pops up here, right? So if you want to change anything on either of them, you just click on it. The first one is here, and then the second one down here. So I'm only, you know, interested on this. So you just click on this one, say, okay, I want to get rid of all the metrics, okay? And then you just remove everything because you are not interested on any. Now inside here, I'm gonna have the profits inside on the label side. So you pick up the profit, you put it on the label right here. Now, since it's a profit, definitely it should be on the dollar sign. So you can right click with format. You're trying to look at the profit here on the field, and you change this to, you know, the default is a number. You can change it to custom currency, and you have the dollar sign. That's it. And we do not want to have a decimal, so you can change this decimal instead of two number to zero. That's it. And then you close this, and then we have it. Next thing, we want to move this inside, and before we do that, we want to change this color, right? We want to change the color inside, you know, to say white. Okay, we want to change this color inside, you know, to white. And to do that, let's try and make it bigger. So click on this, go down to this one, and then size. You want to make it bigger, right? Great, I think this is way better. And this is too little. You may want to change this as well. So click on the second one right here. Change the size. Change the size. Maybe something average. See that? I think this is way better. The next thing you may want to change here is the color. Like I was saying, like, you know, the highlighting inside. We may want to change this highlighting to something you know, different, right? So focus on this one for a minute. And then come down here to say, I want to change this color to white. Are we following? So we change this coloring to white. So when you change this, you know, into white, you know, you can move this right here, this circle, inside this one. And to do so is very simple, right? You just come up here. You want to use this to dual access. Right now, clearly we have dual access, right? We want to tick on dual access. So if we click on dual axis, we are no more going to have any dual axis. We only have only one axis. Clearly you can see we have dual axis because we have this and this. That's like two axes, right? So when you click on dual axis, it's gonna merge these two axes into just one, and that's what we're trying to do here. So you come down here, click on dual axis, and then it's going to merge it, and then voila, we have our donut. Clearly you can see the donut is always actually, you know, we have our donut, right? And the next thing we want to do is maybe to get rid of this line. You know, we are no more interested on this line, which, you know, okay, edit axis, and we are not interested on any of this, right? We don't want the naming. We don't want it. We are not interested on it, and we don't want to have the zero. Actually, you can remove this, right? Take on this one and come down here to ticker. Major ticks, we don't want to have any, right? We don't want to have the tick, and that's it. You know, you reset. Now this line, we are not interested on this line, so we want to, you know, get rid of this line. And to do that, you can right click, you format, you come down here to the formatting, and then you want to get rid of this line. So rows, column, you know, we have all of these, and we don't want the row, so you can come down here to row. Actually, it's the grid line, right? The grid line. And then, you know, we want to remove the grid line. None, you know, yeah, you come down here to zero line, and you want to remove it as well. So now we have a very clean, and then, you know, all white, you know, view. You know, isn't that good looking? And here is the, you know, our donut. So thank you for watching this video, and see you next time.